On today's show, we're going to be taking a look at the Zomei tripod, something that is really quite truly funkalicious. Good morning and welcome to PhotoJoseph's Photo Moment, the first live three times a week show here at youtube.com/PhotoJoseph, all about photography, video, and occasionally things live streaming. Hey, slight different change to the format today. Normally, we do a Q&A at the end of the show, which we are going to do at the end of this show. Normally, that video is listed elsewhere on YouTube separately from this one later, which it is going to be again today. However, the difference is that the Q&A video is not going to be publicly visible. There's a couple of reasons for this. They go back to things that I learned at VidSummit last week. And if you want to know why I'm doing this, click up here and watch the two videos that I did from VidSummit last week, sharing the stuff that I learned. But the only way you're going to get to the Q&A videos, if you want to see those, is to get to the end of this video and click on the link there to the next one. There's a reason for it. It's a good reason. Anyway, so that's the format. So if you want to see the Q&A and you're going, where'd the Q&As go? That's where they are. They're at the end of the main show. So speaking of the main show, let's talk about this thing. This is one of those products that this company reached out to me and they said, hey, would you like to do a review on our product? And I said, sure, why not? And the rest is history. This is from a company called Zomei. There we go. There's their name, Zomei. It comes in a nice little bag, as you can see. And this is a tripod that is a bit interesting. It's got a unique feature that it may not be new to tripods. I'm sure there are other tripods out there that do this, but I have yet to ever see one. Before I open it up, though, I want to show you one of the reasons that I really like this tripod. This is my Think Tank Airporter case. This one is the Airport Advantage Plus. There's a lot of different Airporter models. The whole point of this Think Tank case is that it is the size, the max size for carry-on luggage. And I think this is the international. I don't know, there's like an inch difference between domestic and international. Not that I think you'll ever not get away with it if you have the wrong one, but this is the one that I carry if I'm going to carry a lot of gear and I want to go carry on. So when I went down to VidSummit, I brought this. This was my video bag. Had three camera kit in here, so I had two GH5s, a GH5S, lenses, everything that I need for the video shoot, including the tripod. Now, this is pretty cool. Let me just show this to you. I'm going to open this up. And I don't think that Zomei necessarily intended this. It's just kind of a coincidence. But look at this. Let's go for a top-down view. So here's the really cool thing. This tripod, which is quite a big tripod, fits perfectly in there. This fits inside of my rolling case. I have other tripods that fit inside the rolling case, but they're really small. So this one is like the perfect size. If it was 1 inch bigger, it wouldn't fit. If it was half an inch bigger, you could squeeze it in. It's just absolutely perfect in there. So that is really, really awesome. That makes me super happy. I could fit two of these into here, no problem. I had this one and a smaller tripod in there, and then a platypod as a third stabilization instead of packing three tripods into this. And that worked out really well. So I like that. The length, the size of this is perfect if you've got that particular case. Now I should see as well, It actually would fit inside of the Pelican. I've got my Pelican, what is this model here? Let's just get this up in here. This is the standard Pelican, same thing, goes into carry-on. The I always forget the model number on this. It's written on here somewhere. I think it's on the back, no. Oh, there it is, on the top. This is the 1510. So the Pelican 1510, again, total standard, fits in your carry-on, fits in your overhead luggage. It will fit inside of that as well, but probably with a bit less flexibility just given the layout of that. Anyway. Size-wise, awesome. Okay, so it's a tripod. It fits. Let's see what else it does. Let's see the way it opens up. This is one of those that kind of inverts, so opens down. Now, here we're going to run into what I'm going to say is my first complaint. And I'm complaining without having tried to fix it yet. So it's kind of like, you know, quit your pie hole, stop complaining, and try and fix it. It is really stiff to open and close. Now, there are adjustments on here. I haven't adjusted them yet. Some of the columns are really stiff. I think a little bit of WD-40 would go a long way. But it is, at least out of the box, really stiff. So you might want to get in there with the tools and kind of loosen things up a little bit. Now, the way that the leg goes, you may have recognized, there's a little thumb release here. Push that in, and it will go to that position to stop. Push it in again. It'll go to that position. Push it in again. It will go all the way up to collapse. So it's got really good solid locking at these different positions. You can get it spread out in a variety of different ways, which is always nice. All right, let's get this down, down, and down. There we go. And I'm feeling out of breath. Why am I out of breath? It's like I've been running around like a maniac today. I really haven't. Let's get this down, get this down. We're going to open up all the legs here, get this all spread out so you can see just how high it really is, because that is, of course, kind of an important aspect of a tripod, knowing how high it gets. Did I lock all these? Nope, that one's not locked. All right, there we go. So there's that position. So now we're already at above my eye height. I'm about 5'10", so this I'd have to go up on tippy toes to get up higher, but it goes higher still. If I open this, I can go up higher still. So ooh, that's a little bit too high. Go up higher still, so that's even out of frame. So that's, I don't know, what do you call that, 7-ish feet or so. So that's a good height. Oh, that's a really good height for a tripod that fits into your travel bag. Okay, so that's cool. All right, love that. Bring this back down. You know, it's got a big ball head on the top, standard ball head, nothing too exciting there. Standard quick release plates. It is the Arca Swiss style quick release, so that's all good and well. But here's the funky part. You ready for this? You ready for this funkiness? Okay, I'll bring this back up again. Make sure this is in frame. Ready? Whoa! What? It bends. It goes over. And then, whoa, it goes back this way. Look at this. It does this weirdness. And you think, why would you want to do that weirdness? Well, there's a couple things you can do with this. So if I lock everything else down, let's make sure that's nice and secure. That's open. That is secure. Let me pull it back a little bit. There we go. That's secure. That is loose. Take the ball head. Let's imagine, if you will, the camera's sitting on top of here. Let's see. There we go. Locked in place. Everything's good. I now have a kind of video panning. Now, it's not a centered, like a normal video pan, you would want the tripod spinning part centered over the camera. So you have that type of a pan. And you don't get that. You don't get a perfect pivot off of the center, but you have a kind of an arched pivot right there, which could be just fine depending on the kind of shot you're doing. And you could make that a bigger pivot by pulling this out a little bit and then doing it like so. You could also put the camera facing this way and do kind of an arced push if you did that. And usually, if you're moving a tripod that's not a fluid head tripod this way, you get really kind of jittery motion. But this essentially is, they're not marketing it as a fluid head, but it feels very fluidy, if that makes any sense, inside. So that's pretty good in there. That's a really nice, smooth movement. The other way you can do this, if you're, or the way you would use this, is to flip it upside down. So let's see here, let's say I'm doing this. I got the camera in here pointing straight down. I now have the ability to do something like, well here, even right now at this table, I could do kind of a tabletop photography thing where I could have my camera here pointing straight down and I've got this obviously out of the way of the legs. So I think that's pretty slick. I like that. I think it's kind of cool and funky. So yeah, I mean, other than that, it's just a tripod. It's just a tripod. It feels quite stable. It feels really good. I definitely have held more stable tripods. This is not like Manfrotto Pro level stability. It does have on the bottom here the little bag hook, so you can hang a bag on there. If you've ever wondered why that's there, it's not just a convenient place to hang your camera bag. This isn't a like the coat hook under the bar. It's not for that. I mean, sure, but its purpose is to add weight. By hanging something heavy here, like your bag, and don't get crazy and hang like a 200-pound bag under here, but by adding some weight here, you're adding stability to the whole rig. So that's why you really want to have these hooks on there. This does come off, so you can invert the head as well. So if you wanted to go, gosh, you could take this thing, take the legs at their lowest level, invert the head, stick the head, do this little L bracket sticking out thing, and you could have the camera very nicely stable basically any distance from the surface. So I think you do have complete control. There's no minimum distance that you could position it to the surface. So there you go. That's about it. A little stiff to operate. I think it needs a little bit of loosening. Oh, it does come with a extra column. This is a little weird. It comes with not much. What is this, like 4 inches or so extra column that goes here, except that I have not been able to get the bottom, there's like a protector plate. I cannot get that off. I don't know. I don't know. And it's not going to give you a huge amount of extra length, but it'll give you a little bit. So it comes with this. If you can figure out how to get it on, you're doing better than I am. But this apparently attaches there, gives you a little bit of extra length. So you get a little extra height or a little extra handle if you're doing this type of a thing. So that's about it. That, my friends, is all there is to it. Hey, we're going to wrap it up there. We're going to go into the Q&A. So if you want to do the Q&A, then just stick around for a moment because this actually is probably already on the screen, clicking somewhere here. Anyway, let's answer some questions.